I'd usually start by telling you where I am. Well, let's play a little game. I'm gonna give you a few clues, and as I give them you, let's see if you can guess. It's in the Midlands. Not much of a clue, that is it. It's named after the original person who created the fishery. It's got three phases. I think you're onto something now, aren't you? Yes, we're at Makins Fishery today. And you may be able to see behind me and wonder, where on earth is it at Makins? Because it doesn't look very familiar. That's because we've come onto phase three, which has undergone a major reconstruction. And this is what used to be, and still is, Avon Lake. It used to be a snake lake with a little inner Avon, which is another little lake which accessed via a bridge. Now it's been completely changed. And luckily for me, it's not even been opened yet, and we've been given access for one day to have a little go in the days leading up to it open to see what it's all about. And I'm really excited, feeling really privileged. I can't wait to see what's in this lake. So, what do we know about the brand new Avon Lake? Used to be maybe 16 metres wide at most, maybe 14 metres in parts. Now, it's been well widened. The central inner Avon Lake that used to be there, that's gone. That's now an island, and you've probably got, at a guess, looking at it, 25 to 30 metres. Now, I've spoken to fishery manager Andy Pell, and he's told me that about 2,000 pound of carp, up to 3 pound, have gone in, and about 1,400 pound of bream as well. So it's a mixed lake. So I'm looking forward to having a go at it. I've set two rods up today. I've set a waggler rod up to fish close to the island, and I've set a little hybrid feeder up as well. Plumbing around on the waggler, I found it seems to slope nice and gradually, which is just what you want. So you've got various depths to fishing. So in summer, you can fish tight up in the shallowest water, and as it's cold, they'll come down in that slightly deeper water. So I've pumped for about 3 foot of water out there. And my plan is just to fish pellets, because these fish, I think, and this is, again, it's a bit of guesswork. I haven't grilled Andy too much. I would guess the carp have never been fished for before at that size. So they'll be used to the rattler pellets going into the tank and stuff like that. And that's what they'll associate with the dinner bell. Going to start on the waggler now. Start firing some pellets in, which feels a little bit crazy after the temperatures we had last night. But as I've said, for those small carp, it feels like the right thing. And let's see what happens. So just started on the waggler. Started having a few chucks. I've come on to peg two today. I'd love to know what the hotspots were, but not even open, so not a clue. So it's literally a case of backwind, because I'm fishing a waggler, just trying to get comfortable. There's 20 pegs in total. Looking at the pegs, I'm pretty sure most of them, if not all of them, are new pegs, nice and comfortable. And as you can appreciate, yeah, you know, there's no grass and plants up yet, which is brand new. This will all come up in summer. You get here in 6 months' time when it's the middle of summer, this will be in bloom and this will look beautiful. This ain't the only lake that's been given a makeover. So Seven, which is the one nearest to the gate, for anyone that knows this fishery in the phase, that's been given a similar makeover. Used to be a snake lake. Now it's sort of open water fishing like this with an island. Just changes the landscape, gives something different. Well, Thames and Derwent, they've remained a snake lake. So it's not, you know, it's all about giving something for everyone. And we're in. Taking about 10 minutes. So rattling just a few pellets in. Feels like a little carp to me. So just fishing about 3 foot deep. I've got an 013 knot length on, SLWG. Don't need to go too overgunned. Like I said, these fish, from what I'm told, aren't particularly big. Spirited little fighter. So it's maybe about a pound. Let's break the duck for the day. And we're in. Blank avoided. Always number one job. And they are beautiful little fish. And it's supposed to be loads of those. So fingers crossed, he's not alone. So I've had a good start on the waggler. Caught plenty of little carp on that, up to sort of 2 pound. But not all of you will want to fish like that. So I've decided to have a little go on, a little hybrid feeder. Micro pellets in it, 6 mil pellet. Again, pellets, 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 pellets. That's what we've been fed on in a farm or in a stock pond, wherever they've been. So I'm pretty sure that's gonna be the bait. So I've been casting directly in front of me on the waggler, spraying a few 4 mils over the top. And now I'm gonna cast to my left, because funnily enough, there's no one on the next peg today, which is fortunate enough for me. So I'm gonna chuck there. So I have two separate lines, tight to the island, and see how that goes around. Hopefully, we'll get some wrap rounds. And there we go, second chuck on the hybrid, little pile of bait, quite tight to the island. it's just dropped back, and we're in again. I say, so I think you're gonna have a choice when you come on here, whether you fish a little feeder, a waggler. I think you'd even catch on the pole in open water. But they say the one thing, as I've said several times, just get pellets out. Go to the fishery only pellets. So go to the fishery shop, get the relevant pellets that you need for the tactic that you want to use. These things, absolutely love them. And you're going to get plenty of bites at a time of year when a lot of fisheries are still switching on properly. And again, drops back, then just starts rattling like mad. And we've been at it for about 3 hours now, and it's been non-stop. And you wouldn't expect this sort of action, but it is those naive fish. The bream haven't played ball, it's all been carp. And I tell you what, because they've never been up before, they ain't half feisty. This is probably one of the better fish of the day. Probably in the sort of 2.5 pound bracket. Like I said, this place is absolutely full of them. They've done a sterling job down here. And if this is what we're catching now in these freezing conditions, just imagine how good this is going to be in a few weeks' time when it warms up. When it does open, get down here, you won't regret it.